Abraham Lincoln spoke at a memorial dedicating the cemetery at Gettysburg. Gettysburg was a turning point of the Civil War.
It was the bloodiest battle of the war and in U.S. history. Lincoln wanted to console, inspire, and heal his people and his nation. Here's what he said.
67 years ago, our fathers brought forth on this continent
a new nation conceived in liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal.
Now we are engaged in a great civil war testing whether that nation,
or any nation so conceived and so dedicated, can long endure.
We are met on a great battlefield of that war.
We have come to dedicate a portion of that field
as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live.
It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this.
But in a larger sense, we cannot dedicate, we cannot consecrate, we cannot hallow this ground.
The brave men, living and dead, who struggled here
have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract.
The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here.
It is for us the living rather to be dedicated here to the unfinished work
which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced.
It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us,
that from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause
for which they gave the last full measures of devotion.
That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain.
That this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom.
And that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from the earth.
MEHS Prom 2019 was a labor of true love. Thanks to Alaska Airlines and its Prom Princess program, teams of airline professionals helped the braids become beautiful. From hair and makeup to suits and dresses, the students were pampered and prettied up for the big dance. The students were waiting to enter the dance.
Point of view, no one to tell us no, or where to go, or say we're only dreaming.
A whole new world.
And now here's prom royalty. The king and queen was Leon and Lila. What a beautiful first and last prom picture together. Look at Chad crouch down. The strong, handsome boys held up Ott for a nice picture. The gorgeous girls are finding a pose for a perfect picture. Did prom really happen if you didn't take any pictures? Next year, prom.
Are you interested in telling a story through film? Our Alaskan Stories Season 4 is about to set sail. There's a meeting in Mr. Fitz's classroom on Tuesday. Climb aboard. Join the Google Classroom.
This right here is something that you should dance to. That boom, bap, bamboo, smooth rap, jazz tune. Your last chance to catch.
On the last week of March, the Sitka Fine Arts Camp and the Surge Hospital brought the famous D-Dot Band to campus.
Radio, one of the top 10 bands in the United States, D-Dot, who promises to give us a great program and will be a great audience. Let's give them a nice round extra welcome, D-Dot!
Before stopping by the Cutting Edge Studio for a chance to talk music, fame, family, and future, the Jazz Rap Fusion Quartet electrified the BJ McGillis Gymnasium at the All Student Concert.
Where people are going, you know, just...
I'm Gilbert Anderson, trumpeter of D-Dot.
I'm Mike McLuhan, I'm the electric bass and upright bass player for D-Dot.
My name is Defy, given name Christopher Mike Bitzer. I'm the MC for D-Dot.
Yeah, my name is Nicholas Lucero, and I play drums.
So what brought you guys here to Sitka?
Well, we had a really good opportunity to perform at the Sitka Fine Arts Festival, and the Ethics Search organization also brought us up here to do some workshops and to play some shows. And it's been really great so far. I think we've all been really surprised at how beautiful it is up here. And I know at this particular school we came and we had to perform, and that was with 400 students and from 100 different villages. It just really blew our minds. It was really special for us.
Yeah, I'd never been to Alaska. We always made a joke that when we got here we're going to see people riding whales. Okay.
How did you guys get all together, in the band?
I was going to school, or working at the college actually, in Farmington, New Mexico, where we're from. And I knew Nick from that program there, just playing in the music department. We just kind of kept swinging at it, and now we've been doing it here for like 7 years now,
yeah.
as the three of us, and then we added Chris in, I don't know, maybe 3 or 4 years ago.
Mike used to have this beautiful ponytail. And I just know Mike is the crazy bass playing guy with the ponytail, and I was like, oh, that guy's so good. Just on board.
That's how I felt the same about them, too. They were that big. Yeah, very good musicians.
And I think
they make me want to step up every time they play.
We found out really quick that we were just the same as every other jazz combo. We started digging a lot deeper into our own personal cultures and our interests and likes, and I started studying a lot of these ancient chants of our music, and started sort of pulling from that. That's how a lot of the music sounds the way it sounds. Chris just sort of got on stage and we started playing, and people really liked it, and they said, oh, what? It's such a new sound, it's so different. And so you can imagine a lot of these melodies that we play are driven from, you know, ancient Native American chants. They still have that a little bit of hint of nativeness in it, or whatever you want to call it. But it's starting to take a different direction. We're starting to make a lot better music, and you know, we're all composers.
We played in this theater in Cortez, Colorado, and those guys were really nice to film it for us. And I think out of like 6,500 bands, we were in the top 10 out of those, and like the guitarist for the Black Keys gave us a shout out on their website and stuff, and some other things. And so that really helped us kind of figure out what we want to sound like and what we want to do.
We joke around with each other a lot. I think the chemistry that we all have together, yeah, is really addicting. And I definitely like when we go out to eat, we always have to either try chicken wings or sushi.
It's less, I don't know, it's less like a friendship, more like a brotherhood. You know what I mean? We have,
yeah,
there's times we disagree on stuff and there's times we think, but it's just, there's this other connection that's there. And maybe it's the music that we make and the ability for us to travel, and that is really fun to tap into. You know? So we've done 3-hour shows of original music, which is pretty cool. So.
What I like about it is the fact that we're able to play our music like on the fly, so it's just you know, every night we play is just 80% improvisation, where we're just flying, and it's fun.
Hip-hop, or from an MC's point of view, you usually play beats just like, you know, something you plug in a USB or have a DJ play your beat, and that's fun too. But with the band, like, it's like he said, it's always different every single time. Rapping on a beat from a DJ could just be like, you know, driving in a city or something like that. But then, you know, when you're out with the band, you could be like exploring off terrain areas and things like that. It's kind of how it feels.
That's just it. And the way the four of us play together, we're always just changing on a dime. I mean, we really all pay attention.
So there's really only two notes that could happen at any given time. So we can't be that bad if there's only two notes.
Right.
We can't be that bad.
We need art, you know, all kinds of, there's different art forms now. Once you have that side, then that's you get a really good balance. You know, you're smart and you can, you know, make discerning, emotional human beings is what we want to create. So, and that's really what's going to make the world a better place, mm-hmm. and have people understand. But if you take the arts out of there, it's gonna get really ugly.
I always end up doing a little extra work.
Hey, this is Defi. I'm going to wrap this up right here. Thank you for tuning in to The Cutting Edge. Listen, I'm just an artist and a stylist, a painter with a palette, signature engraved italic. The frame is made metallic. You could call it how you want it. My name is on the ballot. They used to say I wasn't valid. Would it make it? And they doubted by the path that I had taken and the way that it was routed. The face that I was making on that day became nostalgic. I was praying on a mountain. Now I'm laying on an island. Basically, I'm smiling since I refrained from wasting all my talent. I'm thankful that I'm grounded. Blessings overmount what I have counted. They try to build a wall to stop us, but we'll make a way around it. Break free from all the traps and the chains that they have mounted. Thanks for tuning in to The Cutting Edge.
Any final advice, guys?
Oh, yeah. And remember,
stay tuned to The Cutting Edge.